Make the tempo match the game. Games produce all kinds of audio, music, sound effects, voices, and more. In the audio category of videos, I'll be discussing aspects to consider when adding sound to your game. Let's begin. In music, tempo is a measure of how quickly beats occur in a given piece. You may have heard it referenced as BPM. Depending on the content of a game, some tempos fit while others might not. Ultimately, much of this comes down to personal tastes and preferences, but it's something you should always be mindful of. BPM stands for beats per minute. For example, if you're clapping along to a song, BPM is a measure of how many times you'd clap in 1 minute. One clap per second comes out to 60 BPM. Like that, basically. Two claps per second comes out to 120 BPM. As you can see. For Smash Brothers, stage music that's been arranged to feel suitable for battle, we generally go a little over 120 BPM. It ranges from 130 to 170 BPM, on average. Some even reach around 200 BPM, but those are exceptions, not the rule. Even among similar fighting games, the right tempo will vary depending on the speed of the action. Of course, the same applies within one single game where different scenes will call for certain tempos and rhythms. Whether you're a composer or not, it's always good to keep tempo in mind. By the way, in the first Dragon Quest, the deeper you delve into a dungeon, the slower the tempo of the music gets. I think the idea is a very effective one, but maybe a bit hard to implement. You rarely see it in other titles, after all. Stage clear.